Well, I was born very early on a Monday morning in 1965 in a little town named Brooklyn, New York, ready to proudly take my wax and represent the ass end of the baby boomer generation. Well, by the time I was 4 or 5 years old, with Spalding in hand, I was already the king of my stoop and ready to take on the world. My Mama Mia always used to see to it that I was out there making something out of nothing in the neighborhood, too. Hustling everything from Italian ices and homemade lemonade in the summertime to window cactus gardens and hippie ponchos in the winters. But as long as I can remember, the best part of all was simply getting to see the smiles on all my friends' faces. Looking back, that's what did it for me. And now, a few decades later, despite a slightly burnt crust and a few silver whiskers, it's all turning out to be true. It turns out the American dream is still alive, folks. And today when I look in the mirror, I still see the same young Brooklyn boy sitting on that same old stoop. Only now I'm more grateful than ever. See, I got my hard-headed woman, you know, the one I was looking for. I talked to the chickens and I got a hog for a son. Sure, life is good, but I've learned there's no free lunch. I think it was our brother Kermie that said it best. It's not easy being green. A real American story. This here, folks, is a true tale about passion. This is the story of Hogswipe.
That's my slide!
West Palm Beach, and I've just been hog swiped.
Right on, Ronnie!
Who do you love, baby? Hi. Yeah!
Let's
the
ball!
This is a great product, guys.
Okay, rolling.
Howdy, folks. I'm Old Bendover, and this here is my hog swipe on Mary Jo. And welcome to the land of hog swipe. Da 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 da.